Hello everyone, my name is Simran and I am going to teach you mathematics. So students, in the last class we have completed our exercise number 2.4. In that we already had completed our concept, that is fractions. Today we are studying about a very new concept of this chapter, that is about decimals. How well you know about decimals, and we'll be doing the exercise questions of 2.5. Alright students, so let's start with the decimal numbers. Students, the numbers that have the decimal in themselves are called decimal numbers, okay? And today we are representing and learning how well do you know about the decimal numbers. Alright students, here is a decimal number like 253.417, and this point is called decimal. Alright students, this is called decimal. Now we have to expand this number. How can we expand this number? Firstly students, just forget about the decimal, okay? Firstly, we are talking about only 253, okay? Only and only 253. 250 and 3. We are saying this thing in this way, na? 250 and 3. Alright students? So this can be written as 2 into 100 plus 5 into 10 plus 3 into 1. Alright students, this thing can be written in the form of this thing. That is 2 into 100, 5 into 10 and 3 into 1. This thing is the expanded form of this particular number. Alright students, because this number is obtained by doing such operation, by multiplying 2 with 100, by multiplying 5 with 10 and by multiplying 3 with 1 and adding these all, we are getting this particular number. Alright students, and the expansion is important because it tells us about the nature of the number. That is, this 2 belongs to the hundreds. Alright students, okay, and this 5 belongs to tens, and this 3 belongs to ones. Why students? Because in this first part, 2 is multiplied with 100, this 5 is multiplied with 10, and in the last 3 is multiplied by 1, and that is why they are called 100, tens and ones. Alright students, so it is very important to do the expansion if we want to know about the numbers completely, the nature of the number. Alright students, and this also explains that how a number is obtained. Alright students, so this was all about the basic nature of 253, right? Now we'll be having the expansion of the complete number, the complete decimal number, that is 253.417. Alright students, so let's do that. Firstly, this is the same, 253 is the same, so we have discussed it now. 2 into 100, we can write it like this, and this belongs to hundreds. Alright students, 5 into 10, this belongs to tens. Alright students, 3 into 1, this belongs to ones, and all these things are added, okay, to form the cumulative number. Alright students, next we'll be starting with the numbers of point, okay, that is after the decimals. So that is 0.417. whatever is coming, we'll be adding this thing to this. We can also write it as 253 plus 0.4 plus 0.01 plus 0.007, because if you are adding this thing now, suppose 200 plus 50 plus 3, then 0.4. when there is no decimal, you can write it 0.00. Alright students, then 0.01. alright students, then 0.007. then you will be adding this thing, na, complete thing. 0.00077 0.00001 0.01. Alright students, 0.00400, that is 4.003000, that is 3. 0 plus 5 is equals to 5 and 2. Okay. Now you can clearly see, if we have done such thing, the answer would be this only. Alright students, now we'll have to learn how this is obtained. we have done for the part of 2 into 100, 5 into 10 and 3 into 1 and we have added these all. Now we'll be discussing about the point after the decimals, the digits. Alright students, so firstly we'll be talking about 4, okay, this point 4. Alright students, point 4, what is it? It can be written in the form of 4 into 1 upon 10. Why? Because after the decimal, this is the first place, so it is at the 10th position. Alright students, and when it is at the 10th position, it is multiplied by 1 upon 10. As students, this is 0.1, okay? When you are multiplying 4 with 0.1, it is 0.4. Alright students, and this is called the 10th place. Alright students, this is called the 10th place. Talking about the next, that is 0.01. Alright students, 0.01. When you just remove the decimal, how many digits are there after the decimal? 2 digits. So in the denominator, there will be 2 zero over 1. So it is 1 upon 100. Right students? And there is 1. So we can easily do 1 into 1 upon 100. Alright students, and this is your 100th place. Alright student, what is this? This is your 100th place. Alright students, now the next thing, that is 0.007. What is that? We'll be studying about 0.007. Now students, remove the decimal. How many digits are there after the decimal? 3 digits, that is 1, 2 and 3. So we'll be having 3 zeros at the denominator over 1. Okay. So 1, 0, 0, 0. Now it is 7 upon 1000. Right. And it can be written as 7 into 1 upon 1000. Alright students. And this is what? The 1000th place. Alright students. This is the 1000th place. One thing to be remember students, the digit immediately after the decimal is 10th place. The digit at the second position after the decimal is the 100th place. The digit after 2 digits of the decimal is 1000th place. Alright students, now we'll be studying a table. Okay, the expansion in the form of a table. Clearly, this is 253.417 and this is the number is 253.147, not 417, it is 147. So expansion is different. Alright students, now that 253.147, students, it can be written as 200, right? We are saying it like in the form of 253, right? So 2 into 100 plus 5 into 10 plus 3 into 1. Then after first digit after the decimal, that is 1. So 1 into 1 upon 10. Then second digit after the decimal, that is 4. So it is 4 into 1 upon 100. Then third digit after the decimal, that is 7. So 7 into 1 upon 1000. Alright students. Now this is what? 2 into 100. So how many hundreds are there? 200s are there. Now look at this. 5 into 10, okay, it is multiplied with 10, that it means it is at 10th position. Alright students, so how many 10s are there? 5 10s are there. Alright students, 3 is multiplied with 1, so it means how many 1s are there? How many 1s are there? There are 3 1s, okay, so 1s is 3, okay. How many 10ths are there? 10th, this donates the 10th, and how many 10ths are there? 1 10th is there. Alright students, so this is 1. How many hundredths are there? Students, clearly 1 upon 100, this is 100. How many hundredths are there means what is being multiplied with this 1 upon 100? That is 4. So, 100th, 4. Now, how many thousandths are there? 1 upon 1000, what is multiplied with 1 upon 1000? That is 7. So, 7 thousandths are there. And when we are adding these all numbers, we will get this number, that is 253.147. And in this way, students, we can easily solve the questions based upon the expansion of the decimal number. Alright, students. So now we'll be discussing about the exercise of 2.5. Let's start. First question, which is greater? Students, when you need to compare the decimal number, you'll be starting with the greater number, okay, the greater place. Firstly, we'll be considering the 100 place, then tens place, then ones. Then after that, if the ones place is same, then you'll shift to the 10th place. If the 10th place is same, you'll shift to the 100th place. And then if the 100th place is same, then you have to shift to the thousands place. So basically, you have to compare the numbers, that is the decimal numbers, by comparing the bigger place first. Alright students, so let's start with the first question. Which is greater, 0.5 or 0.05? Clearly students, this is starting from the ones place, right? Only ones place is there, so we'll be observing the ones place. Observing the ones place. Clearly students, if I'm talking about the ones place of these two numbers, 0 and 0, this is 0 and this is also 0, so it means that it is completely 0, 0 is equals to 0, so no comparison with this. Alright students, so we'll have to shift to the 10th place, alright, when we are comparing these two numbers for finding which is greater, okay. So now observing the 10th place. Clearly students, this is 5 and this is 0. So 5 is greater than that of 0. So if 5 is greater than that of 0, then it is clear that 0.5 is greater than that of 0.05. Alright students, so this is your answer. Okay, 0.5 is greater than that of 0.05. Alright students, talking about the next question, 0.7 or 0.5, which is greater? Starting with the ones place, okay. Ones place, here 0 is equals to 0, so no comparison, so we'll have to shift to the 10th place. 10th place. Students, it is 7 and it is 5, so 7 is greater than that of 5, right? So it means that 0.7 is greater than that of 0.5. Alright students, 0.7 is greater than that of 0.5, that is the answer. Next question students, 7 or 0.7, which is greater? By observing ones place, clearly 7 and this is 0. So 7 is greater than that of 0, right? So 7 is greater than that of 0.7. Alright students, 7 is greater than that of 0.7, because if we are comparing the ones place, in first number it is like 7 and the another number is 0. So clearly 7 is greater than that of 0. So it means 7 is greater than that of 0.7. Alright students, talking to the next question. 1.37 or 1.49. Firstly, we have to compare the ones place, right? Ones place, clearly you can see in both the numbers 1 and 1. So 1 and 1 are the same, so we have to observe the 10th place. If we are talking about the 10th place, then here it is 3 and here it is 4. So 3 is smaller than that of 4 and 4 is greater than that of 3. So it means that 1.37 is smaller than that of 1.49, and this is your answer, okay. The next question, that is 2.03 or 2.30, what is greater? Firstly, we'll observe the ones place. Clearly 2 and 2, right? So 2 and 2 is equals to same, that is the same. Then talking about the 10th place, students, here it is 0 and here it is 3. So clearly 3 is greater than that of 0. So 2.03 is smaller than that of 2.30. Alright students, and this is your answer. The next question, 0.8 or 0.88. Firstly, we'll observe the ones place. Both are 0, 0, right? 1 is equals to 1, that is ones place. So now we have to shift at 10th place. In this students, if you are talking about the 10th place, it is 8 and it is also 8, okay, so it is also the same. So now we have to shift to the 100th place, right? When there is nothing at the 100th place, it is like 0.8 and this is 0.88, right? And this is 0.88. clearly students, there is nothing. Okay, so if there is nothing, then you can write 0. So clearly at 100th place, 100th place, it is 0 and it is 8. So 8 is greater than that of 0. So 0.8 is smaller than that of 0.88. All right, students, this is your answer. Okay, the next question that we are going to discuss is the question number 2. Express as rupees using the decimal. The parts are given to you in the form of paise, and you have to convert these paise into the form of rupees using decimal. So let's do that, students. Firstly, students, we know that 1 rupee is equals to 100 paise, right? So I can write 1 paise as 1/100 rupees. Right, students? Because in this they are 100 into 1. So I can take this 100 to the division of this 1/100 rupees. All right, students. So just remember this thing. 1 paise is equals to 1/100 rupees. All right, students. First, in the first class, we have to find out how many rupees are there in 7 paises. All right, students. If 1 paise is equals to 1/100 rupee, then 7 paise is equals to 7 multiplied by 1/100 rupee. All right, students. We have discussed in the expansion that it is what? This is 0.01. And when 0.01 is multiplied with 7, it is 0.07. So the answer is 0.07 rupees. All right, students. It is 0.07 rupees. Also, students, you are given this thing, right? You can write it like 7 into 1/100, right? 7/100. How many zeros are there? 2 zeros are there at the denominator over 1, right? Now what you need to do, you need to just keep a little thing in your mind that after the decimal, there should be 2 places because there are 2 zeros at the denominator over 1. So, one thing that is valuable is 7, and before that 7, there comes 0. So, 0.07 rupees is your answer. The next question, students, 7 rupee and 7 paise. We have to convert it into the rupee. This 7 rupee is also already in the form of rupee, right? So, it is 7, and whatever be the answer of this 7 paise, you will just add this to this 7, okay? And we have done the case of 7 paise, that is 0.07 rupees, right? Now we'll just add this 7 and 0.07. So it is 0.07 rupees. All right, students. So this is your answer. Next question, students. 77 rupee and 77 paise. Okay. This is already in the form of rupee, right? So you'll have to add this thing up. 77 paise. Firstly, 1 paise is equals to 1/100 rupee. Right, students? So, if I'm talking about 77 paise, then it is 77 into 1/100, right? So, how many zeros are there? 2 zeros are there. So, basically, write the numerator as it is and you have to put the decimal before 2 digits. So, 1 and 2, before 2 digits, you will place the decimal and this is 0.77 rupees. Okay, 77.77 rupees. This is your answer. All right, students, talking about the next question, 50 paise. 50 paise, right? So 50 into 1/100, right, students? 50/100. There are 2 zeros over 1, okay, in the denominator. So you'll write the numerator as it is. And you have to put the decimal before 2 digits. So, 1 and 2 before 2 digits, just put a decimal and 0 over 1. Okay. So, 0.50 rupees is your answer. Okay, students. Easy. The next question, 235 paise. Okay. 235 paise, students. We know that 1 paise is equals to 1/100 rupee, right? So, 235 into 1/100 235 upon 100. How many zeros are there at the bottom over 1? 2 zeros are there. So we have to put the decimal before 2 digits. Okay. So write the numerator as it is. You have to count the numbers from the right side towards the left. Okay. So 1 and 2. Before 2 digits, place a decimal. So the answer is 2.35 rupee. Okay, students, this is your answer. Next question that we are going to discuss is question number 3. Third question's first part, express 5 centimeter in meters and kilometers. Students, you are given the thing in centimeters, right? And you have to convert it into the meters and kilometers. Alright, students. So you have to convert centimeter to meter and centimeter to kilometer. So let's start for the meter. We all know that 1 meter is equals to 100 centimeter, right, students? So we can write 1 centimeter as 1 upon 100 meter, right, students? We can write this thing, right? 1 centimeter is equals to 1 upon 100 meters. So if we are talking about 5 centimeter, how many meters are there? So in 5 centimeters, there are 5 into 1 upon 100 meters. All right, students? This thing is 0.01. Okay? So 5 into 0.01, it is written as 0.05 meters. All right, students? This is your answer. Okay? Also, we know this thing that 5 upon 100, it means that you have, there are 2 zeros in the denominator over 1. So you have to write the numerator as it is and just place decimal before 2 digits. So 5 and 0. So 0.05 meters. This is your answer. Now we'll be talking about the kilometer section. Okay. We know that 1 kilometer is equals to 1000 meters. Right, students? And if 1 meter is equals to 100 centimeters, then 1000 into 100 centimeters. So 1 kilometer is equals to 1 lakh centimeter, students. Okay. So if 1 kilometer is equals to 1 lakh centimeter, then 1 centimeter is equals to 1 upon 1 lakh kilometers. So now we'll be using this thing to convert 5 centimeter into this kilometer. Okay. Now we have to talk about 5 centimeter. Expressing 5 centimeter in kilometer, will be having 5 centimeter is equals to 5 into 1 upon 1 lakh kilometer, right, students? How many zeros are there over 1 in the denominator? 5 zeros are there. So writing the numerator as it is after the decimal, so after the decimal there should be 5 digits. So 1, 2, 3, 4, and this is 5th digit, okay? 0, 0, 0, 0, 0 kilometers. Alright, students, so this is your answer, okay? 0.00005 kilometer is your answer. Alright, students, the next question. Express 35 millimeter in centimeter, in meter, and in kilometer. Alright, students, we all know about 1 millimeter is equals to 1 upon 10 centimeter, as 1 centimeter is equals to 10 millimeter, right, students? So 1 millimeter is equals to 1 upon 10 centimeter. Okay, students? So 35 millimeter is equals to 35 into 1 upon 10 centimeters, right, students? How many zeros are there at the denominator over 1? 1 zero only. So write the numerator as it is and place decimal before 1 digit, okay? So before 1 digit means this, okay? So 35 millimeter in centimeter is equals to 3.5 centimeters. All right, students? Now convert the millimeter into meters, okay, students? 1 centimeter is equals to 10 millimeter, and we know that 1 meter is equals to 100 centimeter, right, students? And 1 meter is equals to 100 into 10 millimeter. So 1 meter is equals to 1000 millimeter. So 1 millimeter is equals to 1 upon 1000 meters. Okay, students? 1 millimeter is equals to 1 upon 1000 meters. Okay? So 35 millimeter in meter is equals to 35 into 1 upon 1000 meters. All right, students. How many zeros in the denominator were 1? 3 zeros. So, we have to place a decimal before 3 digits. Okay. So, 35 is the valuable thing, right? 35 as it is, and place 00 then. This is 0.035 meter is your answer. Okay. So, in meters, it is 0.035 meter. Okay, students. Now, we have to convert this into the kilometers. All right, students. We know about, now students, we know about 1 meter is equals to 1000 millimeter, right, students? And 1 kilometer is equals to 1000 meters. So, 1 kilometer is equals to 1000 into 1000 millimeters. So, 1 kilometer is equals to 10 lakh millimeter, right, students? And 1 millimeter is equals to 1 upon 10 lakh kilometers. All right, students. Now, we'll use this thing for converting the millimeter into the kilometers. All right, students. How many millimeters should be converted to get the kilometer answer? 35. So, 35 millimeter is equals to 35 into 1 upon 10 lakh kilometers, right, students? How many zeros are there in the denominator over 1? That is 6 zeros. So, after the decimal, you have to put 6 digits, okay? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, okay? Now, students, 35 in the last, then 0, 0. So, the answer will turn out to be 0.000035 kilometers. Alright, students, this is your answer. So, in kilometers, we can say this is 0.000035 kilometers. Okay? This was your answer. The next question, students, that we are talking about is question number 4. Express in kgs, that is kilogram. And these things are given in the grams. Students, we know that 1 kg is equals to 1000 grams. So, if we have to convert 1 gram into kg, then 1 gram is equals to 1 upon 1000 kgs. Alright, students. So, this is the conversion. 1 gram is equals to 1 upon 1000 kgs. Okay. First question, 200 grams. We have to convert the grams into kgs, right? So, about 200 grams. 200 multiplied by 1 upon 1000. Just cut the zeros of the numerator and denominator. Okay. It is 2 into 1 upon 10. 2 upon 10. And it can be written as 0.2 kg. Okay, students. Answer is 0.2 kg. Okay. This is your answer. Talking about the next question, that is 3470 grams. Okay. 3470 grams. 1 gram is equals to 1 upon 1000 kg. So, 3470 gram into 1 upon 1000 kgs. Okay, students. 3470 upon 1000. 3 zeros over 1 at the denominator. So, we have to put the decimal before 3 digits. Okay. 3470. Start from the right side towards the left side. 1, 2 and 3. So, put the decimal before 3 digits. So, answer is 3.470 kg. Okay, students. Now, we'll discuss about the last question. That is 4 kg and 8 grams. This one is already in the form of kg. So, whatever be the answer of 8 grams, we have to add this thing to this kg form. Okay? 8 gram. If 1 gram is equals to 1 upon 1000 kg, then 8 grams is equals to 8 into 1 upon 1000 kg. 8 upon 1000, students. 3 zeros over 1 at the denominator. So, place the decimal before 3 digits. So, it is 8 and then it is 0, 0. 0.008 kgs. Answer is 4.000 and it is 0.008. So, answer is 4.008 kg. Alright, students. this was all about the first four questions of exercise number 2.5, and we have done the expanded form concept also. So this was all about this class. We'll be doing the rest of the exercise, that is exercise 2.5's completion, in the next class. So do practice at your home, students. We'll meet in the next class. Okay, have a nice day. Bye bye.